We're speaking now with Frank Dumas, director of St. George Eco Mining, and today we're going to speak about the Manicouagan project, also known as Manic, that is based in Quebec. And there have been some very exciting results just back, but before we get into those, Frank, could you please introduce us to this project and tell us where it sits in your portfolio?
The Manicouagan project is in the Manicouagan trend. So it's along just north of the Manicouagan Reservoir, which is a meteor crater impact, or a crater that's been created by a meteor impact. And so we're on the northwestern part of the reservoir. This is a project that is accessible by helicopter and hydroplane at this stage. This is a project that, if it was not only accessible via the air, would probably be in the feasibility stage if it was like in Sudbury and, or other place like this, or in the range in Australia. And we are aiming at coming up with a big resource estimate. That's the goal there. So we need to go and put some additional exploration to bring it to a size that will make it something that you cannot just leave there and not go and put an exploitation. So we historically, we acquired this project in 2021, and we've put a good amount of money on it. We have over 10,000 meters of drilling done, and we've discovered a high-grade nickel, copper, cobalt corridor with high-grade associated PGEs. We're talking about platinum, palladium, rhodium, osmium, ruthenium. We have the whole suite there. There's indium and there's iridium in the PGE mix there. We have done some surface work recently. It's important to know in Quebec in the last 2 years, 3 years, there was twice a permitting framework that changed, that canceled all permits, not the license. We still hold the license, but canceled the drilling permits and reset everything. So we had to restart a consultation with the stakeholders, with the community, with the First Nation. And so we're back in that process. We have authorization for surface work, and that was important for us to do the work we've done in September, October, as it was linked to renewal of claims and to the acquisition of permits that are called ATI. So that these are impact permits, where you come with drills, you come with explosive, you come with equipment, hydraulic equipment that will actually move dirt and allow you to do what we usually do in exploration. And we've been lucky. We went to a section that we were really just trying to acquire data, scientific data, and we made a discovery that is pretty far from the main corridor. I'm pretty happy with the results, because it was a two-week campaign initially that was supposed to be supported by helicopter, and we ended up with weather that helicopter were grounded for the duration of the campaign. So this is a campaign that was done with backpack and with guys walking miles and miles in the woods, up and down mountains, to be able to reach the targets that we wanted to sample. And we were able to get a good amount of samples out of there at the end of that campaign. The reality is of that difficulty or that challenge to not have the support of the helicopter allowed us to go and do sediment stream sampling also around the camp of the project, which is an area that we usually don't spend much time. And two samples that were taken, which is stream sediment samples, returned platinum results, platinum grade results, which is interesting, because usually a few ppb of PGEs and sediment streams samples is very encouraging. That tells you that upstreams there's something, and we were not expecting that at all. We were really doing it in a way that it would allow us to acquire some data, allows us to renew these claims, and spend the resource, spend the amount of work that we have to do under the framework to maintain the claims in Quebec. But turned out that was another discovery, the main samples we took from surface, from cutting rocks with a rock saw, from just chiseling rocks, also gave us some interesting results. We were expecting low-grade nickel with some high-grade magnetite iron, which is kind of the setting or the contacts all around that project. We ended up finding nickel and some good grades of nickels up to 2%, and finding platinum palladium on at surface that goes up to 2 grams combined. So it's very encouraging for us. It does expand the focus or the zone that we're going to go after. And we have other targets also that are in zones where we require permits, environmental permits and drilling permits or impact permits. And we hope to have them this year and to be able to go and drill. When I say this year, it's in the coming months, not necessarily in 25, but in the first part of 26, to go at it and have a significant campaign. Now, all this would probably push us to a resource estimate where we want to come up with a maiden resource that will be significant. And we don't want to put a resource right now with the results we have. We could, we think the issue here is if we put a resource of a few million tons of material, it's going to be what's going to define the project. And analysts in 5 years from now will remember the maiden resource. So we want to have one that's going to be something big enough that would be the equivalent of punching them in the stomach and, you know, realizing that, okay, we have something big there that they've kept under the radar for a while.
So it sounds like this project is a long-term play for St. George. Can you tell us what are those big milestones and what sort of timeline are we looking at for the development of it?
Well, there's a few things that are not necessarily in the works, but there's discussion for a partnership with some majors. There's also other type of agreement that could come into play. We, for example, done some microscope pictures or analysis of some of the fine blades of some of the samples to identify the percentage of pentlandite. Pentlandite is the sulfide that usually has the nickel. And we wanted to know, okay, what's the percentage versus pyrite, chalcopyrite, the other type of sulfide that we see in it. And the AI software we're using to analyze the sulfide and give us the percentage kind of point out to another sulfide that is not necessarily extremely rare, but that we're very happy to find there. And it's in Swiss weight and Swiss weight. I always have issue pronouncing that name. But this is a compound that is platinum and bismuth. And so it's PTBI2. And this is a compound right now that people are researching to use as without any transformation as a superconductor for quantum technology, for quantum computers and quantum circuits. So there might be also some development on this now that we know, because I do know some quantum researcher. I reach out and right away there's some interest, and you might see some grant request to do some metallurgical work on this and maybe find a way to preserve that compound in the material and have it produce as a pure, as a product at the end. And we wouldn't need to produce that much to make it a short-term monetization initiative from some of that rocks. And so that would be something. The other aspect is that we're going to go back after winter. We're going to go back to revisit certain areas to do geophysics, an area that we've done some extensive geophysics, but the new area, for example, is not in an area we cover by geophysics. And so we want to know the size of this thing. And even if it's a long-term play, you won't see this project to be in production in 2 years or 3 years. It's going to be 5 year plus. But I'm confident this is a project that one day is going to be in production. It's going to be a big part of the world production, a big contributor, and might not going to be with us. Maybe somebody else is going to buy us out for it. Hopefully that's the dream. And you know, like every other explorer, this is not revenue short term that you're looking at, but it's the multiple hundreds of millions of dollars or the multiple billions of dollars that you could make by selling the resource eventually. Now, in terms of when that resource is going to come, that's going to be below 5 years, within 5 years for sure. And if we're lucky, there's always that element of luck when you do these campaigns. We could probably be moving into feasibility or pre-feasibility within that 5 years horizon. So I'm hoping that we'll get some of the big partners, tier one, tier two companies, to come and support us for that particular project.
Well, Frank, thank you so much for your introduction to that project, Manicouagan. And I and many others are very grateful that it is also known as Manic for short.
Thank you very much for your time.